damage produced by reactive oxygen species. Free radicals are extremely reactive. Their half-life is only a few milliseconds. When a free radical reacts with a normal compound, other free radicals are generated. This chain reaction leads to thousands of events. Peroxidation of PUFA, that is polyunsaturated fatty acid present in plasma membrane, leads to loss of membrane functions. Lipid peroxidation and consequent degradation products such as malone dialdehyde are seen in biological fluids. Almost all biological macromolecules are damaged by the free radicals. Thus, oxidation of sulfhydryl group containing enzymes, loss of function, and fragmentation of proteins are noticed. Polysaccharide undergo degradation. DNA is damaged by strand breaks. The DNA damage may directly cause inhibition of proteins and enzyme synthesis and indirectly cause cell death or mutation and carcinogenesis. Clinical significance of free radicals. Free radicals, normally there is a balance between oxidant and antioxidant in body cells and tissues so that they are not exposed to excessive ROS. However, in many situations, oxidant stress by ROS increases, leading to oxidant injury and various diseases. Chronic inflammation. Chronic inflammatory diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis are self-perpetuated by the free radicals released by neutrophils. Reactive oxygen species induced tissue damage appears to be involved in pathogenesis of chronic ulcerative colitis, chronic glomerulonephritis, etc. Acute inflammation at the inflammatory site, activated macrophages produce free radicals, respiratory burst, and increased activity of NADPH oxidase are seen in macrophages and neutrophils. Respiratory diseases. Oxygen, as you know, oxygen is vital for life, but at the same time, it is very toxic to the cells due to its ability to produce highly reactive oxygen species. These ROS are highly effective as oxidant and cause injury leading to cell death and diseases. Breathing of 100% oxygen for more than 24 hours produces destruction of endothelium and lung edema. This is due to the release of free radicals by activated neutrophils. In premature newborn infants, prolonged exposure to high oxygen concentration is responsible for bronchopulmonary dysplasia. Adult respiratory distress syndrome is characterized by pulmonary edema. It is produced when neutrophils are recruited to lungs and subsequently free radicals. Cigarette smoke contains free radicals. Soot attracts neutrophils to the site, which releases more free radicals, leading to lung damage. Diseases of eye, retinal fibroplasia. Other name of this disease is retinopathy of prematurity. It is a condition seen in premature infants treated with pure oxygen for long period. It is caused by free radicals causing thromboxygen release, sustained vascular contracture and cellular injury. Cataract formation is related with aging process. Cataract is partly due to photochemical generation of free radicals. Tissues of eye, including the lens, have high concentration of free radical scavenging enzymes. Reperfusion injury. Reperfusion injury after myocardial ischemia is caused by free radicals. During ischemia, the activity of xanthine oxidase is increased. When reperfused, this causes conversion of hypoxanthin to xanthine and superoxide anion. At the same time, the availability of scavenging enzyme is decreased, leading to aggravation of myocardial injury. Allopurinol, a xanthine oxidase inhibitor, reduces the severity of reperfusion injury. This is a diagrammatic representation how reperfusion injury occurs. Xanthine oxygen convert hypoxanthine to xanthine, and in this process oxygen is converted to superoxide ions. Atherosclerosis and myocardial infarction. Low density lipoproteins are deposited under the endothelial cells, which undergo oxidation with free radicals. This attracts macrophages. Macrophages are then converted into foam cells, initiating atherosclerotic plaque formation. Antioxidant offer some protective effect. The various free radical toxicity. In eye, free radical cause diabetic retinopathy of prematurity, cataracts, age-related macular degeneration, inhaled tube bronchial asthma and inhalation injury, in abdomen, gastric ulcer, ischemic colitis, fatty liver, in brain, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, in chest, arrhythmia, cardiac infarction, high blood pressure, lower abdomen, kidney failure and uremia, in body, overall body, diabetes, aging, allergy, rheumatic disease, cancer, arterial sclerosis, and face, age spots, wrinkles and sagging. Lipid peroxidation. Lipid peroxidation is very important. It may ask in exams. It is very important. Lipid peroxidation occurs in three phases: initiation phase, and propagation phase, and termination phase. Initiation phase, polyunsaturated fatty acid, that is PUFA, present in cell membrane, are easily destroyed by peroxidation. During the initiation phase, the primary event is the production of carbon-centered radical, that is fatty acid radical, PUFA radical, or lipid peroxide radical by the interaction of PUFA molecule with free radicals generated by other means. Here RH is a PUFA, and OH hydroxyl radical attack on the PUFA to produce carbon-centered radical and water. In the presence of metal ions, fatty acid is converted into lipid peroxide radical. Or lipid peroxide radical and carbon-centered radical inter degraded to malone dialdehyde, a 3-carbon compound. It is estimated as an indicator of fatty acid breakdown by free radical. Propagation phase, the carbon-centered radical rapidly reacts with molecular oxygen, forming a peroxyl radical, which can attack another polyunsaturated lipid molecule. The net result of reactions 2 and 3 is conversion of carbon-centered radical to hydroperoxide, but there is simultaneous conversion of a carbon-centered radical to a peroxyl radical. This would lead to continuous production of hydroperoxide with consumption of equimolar quantities of PUFA. One free radical generates another free radical in neighboring molecule. A chain reaction or propagation is initiated. Termination phase, the reaction would proceed unchecked till a peroxyl radical reacts with another peroxyl radical to form inactive products. Role of antioxidant. There are two types of antioxidant. First of all, what is antioxidant? Substances which protect against cellular injury by ROS or other oxidants by scavenging them are called antioxidant. Generally, it is of two types: endogenous and exogenous. Exogenous antioxidants are generally nutritional elements and